Welcome to another Looker Studio tutorial. Today we will show you how to connect to MySQL server, using a data source, and then, create a report, using that data source. Go to Star Bakery data set page. Here you will find all the information to connect to the database. Now, open the Looker Studio, and click on the Create button. Here you can create reports, and data sources. You can create a report, without creating a data source in advance. You can create one at the time of report designing. However, we will first create a data source, where we will connect to the Star Bakery data set, using MySQL. Click on the Data Source button. This will open the data source window. Here you can connect to your data source, using various available connectors. We want to connect to MySQL server, therefore search for MySQL in the search bar. This will display your relevant connectors. We will select MySQL by Google, to connect to MySQL database. In the next window, we will provide the information necessary to connect to our MySQL server. We will copy the information from Star Bakery data set page. The information includes server IP address, database name, username, and password. The server is available for everyone. You can also use it for practice. Once all the information has been provided, you can click the Authenticate button. This will display all the tables available in the database. Select the Star Bakery table, and click on the Connect button, to connect to the Star Bakery table. Once you are successfully connected to the database, the Looker Studio will display all the fields available in the selected table. Each field has the information of its data type, and default aggregation, which can also be changed here. On this page, you can also create additional fields and parameters. To learn how to, watch our Looker Studio, Understanding the Essential Concepts and Techniques video. You can change the name of the data source, to an appropriate one. Now, you can use this data source, to create a Looker Studio report. Click on the Create Report button, to create a report using this data source. A prompt will ask for your permission, to add the data source, to your report. Click on the Add to Report button. Now you have all the fields from your data source, which you can use to create visualizations in your report. Let's rename our report first. One table has already been added by Looker Studio, which you can delete if you want to. First, let's delete the auto-generated table visual. Now, we will add a pie chart, to display sales by product. We will define the grid size, and then select the Snap to Grid option. This will help us place our visuals in perfect positions. Now, let's arrange and position our pie chart. By default, record count has been added to the metric. Let's replace it with the total price field. Now we can see all products, by their total sales. Let's copy the same pie chart, to display sales by salesperson. We will replace product field in dimension, with the salesperson field, to display sales by salesperson. Now, the chart is showing all the salespersons, and their respective sales, as percentage. We will create a duplicate of this pie chart, to display sales by order type. We will replace the salesperson field in dimensions with the order type field. This chart shows us sales by the order type. Let's add a combo chart to display sales and weight by date. Replace product in dimensions with date field. Let's edit the date field and display only months. We also need to replace the record count field with the weight field. Now, we need to move one of the fields to the right axis. To do this, go to Style area and change the series 2 to right axis. We are done with the combo chart. Now, we will add a scatter chart to compare sales price with the weight of product. Looker Studio has already added the weight and total price to the metrics X and Y. No further changes are required here. Finally, we will complete our dashboard by adding a title using the text box visual. We will add an appropriate text to act as title to our dashboard. Let's change the size of font to make it prominent. Let's set the font size to 72px or 60px. Our dashboard is now complete. Let's go to the view mode and see the result. Thanks for watching our tutorial. We hope you liked our video. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more tutorials and updates.